Hello, we are going to paint some mugs today. Now this is a black and white shot and I've turned up the values. That means I've made the darkers darker. Now since this is a smaller canvas, it's only 8x10, I'm going to be using a smaller brush. Just because. So anyway, what you're going to do, you're going to mix the block in colors. You're going to take a little bit of your ultramarine blue, a little bit of your red, and you're going to mix this together till it looks like a dark purple color. Okay, it almost looks black. A little bit more blue. A little bit more blue because it's going too much to the red. And then I'm going to take just a tiny, tiny little smidgen of the yellow and put in there. And that's going to turn it even more duller into a black looking color. And this is acrylic, so we'll be using water for our medium to rinse our brush. So I will start blocking in and drawing in my mugs. Now, don't be afraid that this is too dark. It's all going to be covered up in the end. And I'm just going to put in all my lines. Now, I have my lines already drawn in here. If you want to just freehand this with the brush, you can. But I don't like to stress out that much, so... I've got that mug drawn in, and now I'm going to draw this mug in. Okay, I've got them drawn in. I'm going to go ahead and freehand that placemat in a little bit here. Just kind of put an arc in here. There's not much of it showing. Oh, it's higher than that. So, to here, to here, and... When you trace that, if you trace it, you could do that or put that in. I didn't do it when I did that. So, okay, I've got my placemat in there. Okay, the next thing I'm going to do is use that last photograph, the first photograph I put up there. And I'm going to block in my dark colors. Now, don't let this scare you. I'm going to put in... this dark shadow that's here on this side of the mug. Now, don't worry about putting in the different colors of this mug. If you want to do that, you can. It is a handmade mug, so it's got different colors in it. If you want to make your mug all one color, go right ahead. It's okay. I'm going to put in my shadows here. Shadows inside there. There's shadows there. And I'm going to put just a little bit down here, just for the fun of it. Because that'll make that handle pop out a little bit more. And our sun is our light source is coming down this way. And then on this little guy over here, his dark shadows are going to be over here. And again, don't let this dark purpley blue color scare you. it's okay. And then we have some shadow back here from this mug shining this way. We've got some shadow in here. Now you can still see a little light in there, so you can still see the edge of your mug. If you lose it, don't worry. And then there is some dark over here for the shadow on this mug. And that looks pretty good there. Now for the inside of our mugs, this one's really dark, but it's lighter over here. So let's really darken this side up. And then just do kind of a wash shadow around over here. That's just your paint with water in it. Kind of a lighter color there. And I want it darker inside here. You might have to wait for that to dry first. And then this side over here, I'm going to have some help from the dogs here in a second. They're going to be whining inside here. There is shadow. And there we go. Okay, now we've got our shadows and our drawing in. The next thing I will be doing is doing a block in. Now, I'm not worrying about detail here. I'm just worried about values. So what you need to do is to pop up your color photograph next to this black and white photograph. I can get that done here. And I'm going to leave the colors the way they are because that'll be the easiest thing to do. If you want to do another picture after this one and change the colors of your mugs and stuff, go right ahead. But the color back here is a little bit darker color than this mug. It's actually the table, and the table is sort of a sienna color. And to mix a sienna, you're going to mix your red and your yellow ochre. And that's going to give you kind of a sienna color. Now, when you're doing a painting, you want to keep your eye within this painting. So to do that, or to help do that, you want to put darker in the corners. And since our light source is coming from this direction, we're going to have the same color in the background. Sometimes, like if your light was coming this way, one side of your canvas would be lighter than this side. But we're just going to be face on here. So I'm going to just block in here. I'm not worrying about doing any detail. I'm putting in darker in my corners. And I think when we're done with this, I'll bring this up about how these dark corners help make your eye stay within this canvas. You don't want to lose your viewer. You want them to stay within the canvas and not view off the camera or off the canvas. Now to lighten this, I'm going to put just a teeny, teeny little bit of white in here. And that'll get me a lighter value. We will go just a little bit lighter. One thing about acrylics will dry a little bit darker than the think I'm gonna make that a little more brownish or yellowish here. Okay, the next thing, I'm gonna stick just a tiny little smidgen of blue in there, just a little tiny bit, and try and bring this down to a, not a green color, but a darker sienna color, not so brilliant. And let's see if, yeah, there we go. I'm gonna blend this into this dark corner here. You can get, I'm not using any retarder here, and that is what slows down your paint. I'm not using any, but if this acrylic paint dries too fast for you, I also use a spray bottle, and I spray my paint on my palette. I used to spray it with the water. That keeps everything dried or wet. Okay, now I just pulled a little bit of that darker back in here. This is the lighter color. And do kind of a hash-tash with your brush. I don't know if you've kind of paying attention to what I'm doing. If you've got a wrapped canvas, go ahead and paint your sides so you don't have to go back and do that. If it's a flat canvas, no sides, then you don't have to worry about doing that. But there, we got that. Get this in here. Get my arm out of the way. And again, this is called the block in. This is your roadmap to where your painting's going. Like I say, we're not doing any detail, we're just getting the values in here. That's and the value is the intensity, or the how light and dark these colors are. Now, the placemat is going to be a lighter color. And since I do not, if you've got your full palette, get your cerulean blue, or your lake blue, your turquoise blue. It's kind of a color like this. Whoops, I dropped it. Like this. Get just a bit of that, and we'll put in our little placemat. And again, I'm going to go darker down this corner, get light here, and darker in the back. I'm going to mix a little bit of that ultramarine blue in there too. Just, oops, we got a little bit of the background color in there, but that's okay. I'm going to end up picking this up. And the cat's going to start howling. Okay, in case I missed it in the last video, didn't take, I'm going to use cerulean blue, a little bit of white, and a touch of ultramarine blue. And I'm going to put this placemat in. I'm going to use the darker down here in this corner, darker in this corner, and darker in back. And this is going to, yeah, I lightened that just a little bit because that was too dark. Since it's a circular placemat, I'm going to kind of go in a circular motion here with my brush. That'll give it a little bit of detail. But don't worry about too much detail right now. We're just blocking in the colors. This is called the block-in. Another thing this helps you to do is to get rid of all the little white canvas. This is just an underpainting. It will mostly, all of it will be covered up in the end. I'm going to make sure I get my edges painted. I'll probably do that off camera. But okay, I'm going right over the top of that shading of the purple. Just go right over the top of it. And if you notice, some of your paint's going to show through there from the underneath. That's okay, because that's where your shadow is. If you can see that underneath here, there's the shadow back there. I'm going to put this in. And again, try to get your white areas covered. That's what this is for. Okay, now that's pretty done. Now this mug with the blue, you can dip right out of your ultramarine blue and start putting some of your blue in here. It's kind of a brilliant blue here. Go right over the top of that purple. And while you're painting, use your brush to sort of go to the curvature of your mug. That'll really help when you get ready to do your final coverage there. And there's blue there. There's quite a bit of blue you can see back here in this lighter area here. You can see that. Okay, we've got block in there and block in there. The bottom of that little mug is kind of a copper color. So again, you'll match your alizarin crimson. Pretty much like you did this, but just a little bit lighter. A nice little copper color, and we'll go ahead and put that in. Now over here in this shadow, I'm not pushing down on the brush as hard as I am right here where I want a lot of paint on. I want some of this shadow to shine through here. You can see where that shadow is shining through there, and we've got some of this color up on the handle. That's what this is. I need to get some of that brilliant blue and put, oh, you silly thing. Oh, I guess it's recording. I thought it stopped recording. Some blue here. There's that. Now, later on we're going to darken up that smaller mug, but for now we're going to use again alizarin crimson and a little bit of your yellow ochre, and I'm going to make it go more to a red color, just to or maybe no, more of a orange color. Let's go more orange here. So put more yellow ochre in it and a little bit of white, and I'm going to make this mug just a little bit lighter than what's in the picture, but well, probably still too dark. Let's go just a little bit lighter. Put this again here. Now I didn't mix my paint very well, so I've got some streaks in there, but this is our mid-tone on this mug. Um, And so I'm going to go right over that shadow. Now I know on this one your eye won't see that shadow under there, but it's there. I kind of lost my hand a little bit, but I can put that back in there. I know inside of this mug it's darker over here because of the glaze is a darker glaze, but I'm going to go ahead and put this color on the inside just to give it a little more brilliancy there. Handle on here. Now if you have to get a smaller brush to do this, I know it's harder with a bigger brush. If you have to get a smaller brush, don't get a tiny, tiny one, because you'll be doing this all day long. So okay, that is my block in. At this stage I can look at this and go, well, maybe I don't like this so dark here. Maybe I don't like the color of this mug, or I don't like the color of this, or maybe the one mug is lopsided or something. Your next step, you'll be able to fix some of those things. There are a few little bit of white spots on this canvas. I'm going to go off camera. I'm going to cover up those white spots, and I'm going to paint around my edge, and then we'll be ready to start detail. Now comes the point where we're going to look at this picture and kind of see what we need to change. I'm going to make in my final project, I want my placemat lighter. I want some color differentiation in my background. And then I'll put more detail in the mugs. Put more detail in the mugs. I will try to straighten out my camera, maybe. And mix up a lighter color of this turquoise. There we go. I'm not going to bother about putting those lines that are in the placemat on here, because that's just something harder to do. And for now, we'll just leave them off. Oops. Too much. There we go. Yeah, as I come out here, I'm going to just kind of hashtag that together here and blend it. I have run over my mug a little bit, but that's okay because we see it there. That lightened that up a little bit down there. I'm going to do just a little bit more. When I rinse my brush, I usually rinse my brush and dry it off in a paper towel, like blot it. Like I just dipped it in water, blotting my brush. I'm going back in here with a wet brush, not so much paint on it, because I'm just going to blend this in here. A little still lighter down here. I want more light coming through here. And I'm not going to worry about my edges right now. I'm going to come back afterwards. And get those edges. Now it's okay to see some brush marks in there. And then I'm going to blend up into here. My blending, I just dipped my brush in the water, dabbed it in the paper towel. It's sort of what's called a scumble, where just a little bit of paint on a brush and water. Now that has given me a darker value in this background of this placemat. And I think that's where I want to leave it for now. One thing about acrylics, it dries fast. If you don't like it, you can just wait a little bit and you can change it. Not so with oils. Okay, I've mixed up my purpley blue again, and I'm going to put my shadows back in here that I lost. So I'm going to just put a little paint on my brush, come in here. And I'm going to darken up the value on this side of the brush here, or on this side of the mug. Now I'm rinsing my brush, blotting it in my paper towel. It's a clean brush now, or pretty clean, and I'm going to blend in this with the rest of the mug. And this is my shadow here. Now I may go over that again with a little bit more sienna, but for now, we'll just leave it and see how we like that. I'm letting up on my brush. I'm not pushing down quite as hard on it. There. Okay, I'm going to dip my brush back into my dark purple color, and I'm going to start putting this shadow back into this mug, or the rim of the mug, or the inside of it. Now, if you notice, there's the painting underneath is showing through, but that's okay because I want that to happen. Some white on my canvas there. My sienna has dried up, so I'm making some more. It's a little too dark. Now when I'm going over where that shadow is, I just barely lightly went over that with this brush. I wasn't pushing down real hard on it. I'm going to get a lighter color and go in here. It's kind of a, use some of that yellow ochre. I'm trying to make that like look like that sun is hitting it right there, and it's, or the light or the sun. And that's what we did. See how that rug? See how that mug is starting to take on some dimension? Going to mix up a really light color of that. I used to put a little bit of more white into the sienna color, and I'm going to just very lightly touch some highlights on here. It's going to make that look like this, that light is hitting on there. I'm going to come over here on this rim where it's, where the light is hitting it, and just barely. That's probably too much, but I can go back and take some of that out, and I'll show you how to do that. in a little bit. One thing about my videos is that I don't take out the mistakes. I leave them in so you can see how to fix it. I'm going to fix it just a little bit here. I rinsed my brush. I have a dry brush, rinsed out with paper towel. And I'm just removing some of that along that rim there where I didn't want it. Okay. I'm going to work on this handle just a little bit more. We've got light coming here. Here we got light. My brush is too dry. Okay. Yeah, I had some of that purpley blue in my brush and it was really not letting that light show up. I'm going to need to get a smaller brush and work on some of that detail there, but we'll just leave that for now. Okay, we're going to let that mug dry a little bit. And I'm going to come over here and I'm going to hit this one a little more. And go more, see if I can get more of a coppery color here. A light coppery color. Nope, that's not quite coppery enough. And to get the copper color, I'm using the alizarin crimson. Sort of just the same color as this, but I want it just a little bit more brilliant. I'm going to put in just a little bit of cadmium yellow into this and watch what the cadmium yellow does when you put cadmium yellow and alizarin crimson together. You're going to get a brighter color, a more intense color. Yep, there we go. Still too dark. Let's see if this will. There we go. And I'm going the direction of that mug. Kind of swirling that around there. Now I have rinsed my brush, got a dry brush. Not totally dry, but I rinsed it out. And I'm going to blend some of this yellowish color into there. Like that. Now, on this mug, you can really see it. See over here, that underlying purple that we did in the first place? That has put a shadow in there. It just helps you. You don't have to do as much work. I'm going to take just a little bit of a real light yellow color. Real light yellow. Not white, a real light yellow color. And I'm going to put a few more highlights. I might have to wait for this to dry a little bit. A few more highlights in there. On the blue, again, I'm going to use that ultramarine blue. Put just a tiny bit of white in it. And I'm going to come over here and let the light hit this inside of the cup. I'm rinsing my brush. drying it in the paper towel. I have the dry brush. And now I'm going to attempt to blend this in a little bit here and get this where that light is hitting. I need a little more paint. I've probably got too much light in there, but I will get a little more of my purpley blue color. My paint is drying really fast today. Spray it with water. Come back in here and put some of this shadow back. Again, go the direction of your mug. There we go. Now I've put that shadow back in there. I might come back and put a little more light in there. You can see I've got some white too showing in there. So I put a little bit of white paint into the purple color. I'm going to put this rim on here because the rim is lighter and I want it lighter than that purple that's on top or on the bottom there. So I put that rim back in on that mug. I'm going to go ahead and put that handle in again with this color too. I'm gonna let this dry because I need to darken this up in here just a little bit. There's too much light showing through right in there. I need to have a smaller brush. This is a watercolor brush. Don't use a watercolor brush. I don't want to go get another brush right now. Put that blue handle in a little bit more. A watercolor brush, the bristles are really don't hold up very well. So it's kind of hard to paint with when you're using acrylics. So I wouldn't suggest using a watercolor brush, but I don't want to stop right now. Okay. I think I will stop, go get a smaller brush, and let this paint set up. Okay, I'm back. I have a smaller brush. I'm just almost done here. I come in here and put a little bit of highlight on this mug here on the handle where the light's hitting it. That's too much, so I'm gonna take a little bit of that off. There it goes. That should have been blue instead of peachy color, but we'll just... Again, I wiped my brush off, or washed it off. Now I'm just gonna grab a little bit of light blue instead of the white, light blue and white, and put a little bit of highlight on that handle there. There's not a lot of paint on this brush. It's mostly just water and just a little bit of paint. Put a little more of a highlight over here. A little bit, kind of just skipping and jumping that. I don't want a solid line across there. Very good. That rim, I want to stick a little bit more dark. Down here in this shadow. A little bit over here. Now, I'm putting this up on the internet for free. You can find it at my YouTube channel. And that's Connie Mason-Bennett, I think. There's links. I'll have a link to my Facebook. It'll take a while before I can get that up. Not Facebook, but to YouTube. It'll be a little while before I can get that up there. Because it takes quite a while for it to download. But I will be having my sunflower and mug painting class again, but I'm going to have a prerequisite that you show me that you've done this one before you do that. And I will also have a free sunflower lesson too. And that's my cat. Let's see, a little more highlight here on the rim of this mug. I'm using a liner, script liner right now. That'll and put a little more highlight there. This is what I call being fussy, where I go in and start really messing with things. I want a shadow underneath here. I need a bigger brush for that. I've put in a little dark there, and I'm just going to take this brush and kind of just on the back side of that handle. And that'll make it look more like the back side of the handle where the light isn't getting to it. And just kind of blend that in a little bit. I want to hit a little more highlight on the handle. Let's see, I'm going to put a little bit on this little knob here. A bit more. There's a light hitting there. Light hitting there, and get me a light streak going here a little bit where that light is hitting. Now again, I'm rinsing my brush out, wiping it down, and then I'm just going to blend this in a little bit here. And it's, so that looks like that's okay. That put a little more highlight on there. I think we're good on the rest of it. Oh, got a shadow where the mugs are sitting on the table. So we're gonna come back in here. Now you can kind of still see it under there. I'm going to put, my brush is just a light wash of that purpley blue color. Again, you would take this off to the side here. You can't really see that when I have my arm in the way. I'm just going to put that, I'll kind of just set this down on here. I'll put a little bit of there. This is Drizo. Then I'll set this. This is pretty dark back in here. You'll see what putting this shadow does. Putting this shadow in here really helps to anchor this down onto the placemat. A little bit back here. I think I need to lighten this just a little bit. And blend that into here. Letting the light hit the back of that just a little bit. You could fuss with this all day long, but get it to a point that you like it and sign your name to it, and you're good to go. And again, I will be having my sunflower and mug class lesson again, but I want to do some quick little lessons here to get you acquainted with the acrylics and to see if taking the big class is what you want to do. Okay, I'll assign my name to this. When you sign your name, there are some people who like to make sure you can see the name, but okay, it's ready to go. We'll see you next time.